We introduced in a previous tutorial the Aladin stack, which is the pile of individual planes that have been loaded during your Aladin desktop session. You can click and drag the plane icons in the stack to change their order, just like this. This can be useful because the view in the main panel is looking through the stack from the top. There are different sliders at the bottom of the stack for adjusting respectively the opacity level, the size of the symbols, or the zoom factor. If you want to view the two mask image with some transparency on top of the DSS2 image, make sure the two mask plane is on top of the DSS2 one, select the two mask plane and use the opacity slider at the bottom, like this. You can also use the small slider on the trapezium icon of the plane directly, like this. If you want to view the DSS2 image on top of two masks, drag one of the planes to change their order, for example, like this. Make the two mask plane the reference one and use the slider of the DSS2 plane, like this. You can also use sliders to change the size of catalogue plane symbols. For example, for the Simbad plane, you can change the size of the symbols with the slider. And if there are proper motion measurements in the plane, use the epoch slider to compute the positions of the sources at different epochs. If you use the multi-view mode, for example, the four views here, you can click and drag some planes from the stack to assign them to specific panels. For example, two masks here, always here, and another image here. So I'll switch back to single view. And this is two plane. You can organize your stack in folders via the pop-up menu. Just right-click in the stack and choose to create a stack folder. You can then move planes to this folder, for example, the two mask catalog and the two mask image. And in that case, you can use this folder to view only the two mask sources on top of the two mask images. If you leave your mouse over a plane's icon or name, you can display additional information at the top of the stack panel. You can see this for different planes here. There is an option to backup the full stack under File and Backup the Stack here, which should save most of the current state in a local file and allow you to reload it later in Aladin. Thanks for watching, and feel free to leave your own tips on using the Aladin stack as a comment below.